Hello, how are you, my dear students? I hope all of you are in a great spirit and making proper use of your time. Students, in the previous chapter, we have studied about the sentence. What is a sentence? A group of words which are arranged in a manner to convey a complete sense. Means a group of words coming together to give a complete sense or a specific meaning is called a sentence. Example, the sun rises in the east. My dear students, every sentence consists of two parts. Every sentence is consists of two parts, that is subject and predicate. Whether it is interrogative, assertive, exclamatory, or imperative, whatever is the sentence consists of two parts, that is subject and predicate. Example, mango is my favorite fruit. Mango is a subject. In this part, we name a person or a thing we are speaking about. Means we used to name a person or a thing about whom we want to speak about. In the second part, that is predicate, in this part, something is said about that person or a thing. Something is said about the subject. Something is said, but whatever is said in this part is said about the subject. Now, my dear students, here are some more points about subject and predicate. No sentence can be formed without a subject or a predicate. Means we cannot make a sentence without a subject and predicate. The second point is the subject may consist of one word or several words. In the same way, predicate may also consist of one word or several words. For example, I sang. In this example, I is subject and sang is predicate. Just one word, I is a subject and one word, sang is a predicate. In the second sentence, a very tall and a muscular man appeared before me. A very tall and a muscular man is a subject and appeared before me is a predicate. See, a subject is of number of words and predicate too is having number of words are there. So we can say a subject may consist of one word or several words. In the same way, predicate can also consist of one word or several words. Third point, the subject of a sentence usually comes first, but sometimes it is put after the predicate. You all know that subject usually comes in first, but sometimes we are putting it at the end also. Like in this example, here comes the bus. The bus is a subject and it is at the end of the sentence. So I hope you understood, subject can be at the end also. Fourth point, in imperative sentences, the subject is generally omitted. You all know what is imperative sentence in which some order or command is given. In this, we are not giving subject. It is omitted. Because we know what is going to be the subject, so we are omitting it. We are not writing subject. Example, sit down. Here the subject you is understood. You sit down. Isn't it? Thank him. Here too the subject you is understood. Now the fifth point, in interrogative sentences, the subject usually comes in this pattern. Example, can he help you? He is a subject. Are you blind? You is subject, is coming in between the sentence. Now the sixth point, in exclamation sentences, the subject usually comes in this manner. What a nice chap you are. So, my dear students, I hope it is clear what is subject and predicate. The part which names the person or a thing we are speaking about is called a subject, and the part which tells something about the subject is called predicate. Now, students, read the chapter by your own thoroughly. And try to do the exercise for better understanding. I will send you exercises and definitions tomorrow. That's all. Take care and be strong and peaceful.